Hi friends, welcome once again to another session in the transcription. We will discuss the basic rules of transcription today. Let's move ahead. Transcription is nothing but synthesis of RNA from DNA is called transcription, and the enzyme that is required is called RNA polymerase. In the presence of RNA polymerase, the process of transcription takes place, and it is the basic step for the gene expression. And this RNA polymerase, we have seen in our previous video that in prokaryotes there is one type of RNA polymerase which synthesizes all the RNAs, mRNA, rRNA as well as tRNA. And in eukaryotes, there are three types of RNA polymerases: RNA polymerase 1, RNA polymerase 2, as well as RNA polymerase 3. RNA polymerase 1 synthesizes rRNA, RNA polymerase 2 synthesizes mRNA, RNA polymerase 3 synthesizes tRNA. Okay, with this introduction, we will move on. And this RNA polymerase, it do not need primer. Primer is necessary in the process of replication. Primer is short oligonucleotide fragment which contains free 3' hydroxyl group. But this free 3' hydroxyl group is not necessary for the process of transcription. That means RNA polymerase, it has the ability to add the first nucleotide by itself. And this strand from which the new strand is derived. Remember, if this is the DNA strand, double helical DNA, from which the RNA is synthesized, this is RNA strand. From which the new strand is synthesized, this is called the template strand. The template strand is also called as antisense strand, non-coding strand, or minus strand. Why? Let us see why it is called as antisense or non-coding strand. See here, this in this figure, if we carefully observe this sequence, this is the blue one is double helical DNA where it is unwinded and the RNA is being synthesized here. And from where the RNA is synthesized? From this strand, the RNA is synthesized. So this strand is called as template strand. And this is called as non-template strand. The lower one is called as non-template strand. If we see the sequences of template strand and newly synthesized RNA, if A is present, U is there. If thymine is on the template, adenine is present. If guanine is there, cytosine is present on it. That means the sequences, they are complementary in nature between the template strand as well as the newly synthesized RNA. When we see this another strand, that means this is called non-template strand. In the non-template strand, if we compare the sequences of newly synthesized RNA and the non-template strand, the sequences are entirely similar except uracil in place of thymine. All the other sequences are exactly similar. That is why this non-template strand is called a sense strand and this template strand is called as antisense or non-coding or minus strand. Is it clear? Let's move to our topic. Let's go back. Okay, after knowing the difference between the template and non-template, antisense and sense strand, this transcription process also needs NTPs. NTPs are ribonucleotide triphosphate. The precursors which are needed are ATP, GTP, CTP, and UTP. These are required for the process of transcription, and the process of transcription takes place in the nucleus in case of eukaryotes, and there is no preformed nucleus in the prokaryotes. It takes place in the cytoplasm itself in the prokaryotes. For the process of transcription, it also needs magnesium ions and manganese ions, especially bivalent metal ions are needed, and the promoters are required for the process of transcription. What are these promoters? Promoters are the short sequences which are similar in all the organisms. Suppose if this is the start point from where the RNA is synthesized, and these sequences are called downstream sequences from which the RNA is synthesized, and towards the left of the start site, these sequences are called upstream sequences, numbered as -1, -2, -3, like that. At there are promoter sequences, one at -10 region, another one at -35 sequences. And these promoters are, for example, if we see -10 region, TATAAT sequence is present. This sequence is required for the process of transcription. How it is required means the RNA polymerase enzyme. Imagine if this is the RNA polymerase enzyme is there, it first recognizes -35 promoter sequence, and then it knows that there is another promoter at -10 region. It will be moving on the template strand for searching the promoters. Once it recognizes the promoters, it is very sure that the start site is very near. That is why the promoters are useful. -10 and -35, two promoters are required for the prokaryotic transcription, and this RNA strand is synthesized from always from 5 prime to 3 prime direction. If we put here, the RNA strand is synthesized, newly synthesized strand, whether it is RNA or DNA, is synthesized from 5 prime to 3 prime direction. That means the template is present in opposite in polarity, so that the newly synthesized strand is synthesized from 5 prime to 3 prime direction. Okay, and the polymerization rate of this prokaryotic RNA polymerase is 50 nucleotides per second. In a second, it can add up to 50 nucleotides to the new strand. And this prokaryotic RNA polymerase contains 6 subunits, 2 alpha subunits, 1 beta subunit, beta prime subunit, sigma, as well as omega 6 subunits are present. Large multi-complex enzyme. I made another video on this RNA polymerases. Watch this video for this RNA polymerases. And these are the basic rules of transcription. With this introduction, we will move on to the mechanism of transcription.